us? Kasi there was an email by the registrar to actually submit all grades before April 23, but the AIS website or even the SIS website did not specify. Hindi naman kasi klaro yung ating ano. March 7 to 18 ang pre-listing. So summer classes will be from April 11. So kailan daw yung enrollment? March 23 to April 10 yung enrollment. So siguro March 23 yung deadline of grades. Okay? Do you follow? Okay, so we have a month and a half, no? To finish the whatever. I think we'll be finished ahead, no? I think of the way we are going, no? So any questions so far? So we'll have a formative assessment lang, a summative assessment, no? And then I'll just include your assignments in the grades. Okay. Okay. So last meeting we discussed memory. Okay? Do you follow? Tapos na ba tayo? Tingnan natin ngayon yung last meeting. Computer memory organization introduction. Okay? So dito tayo ngayon sa memory map cache, no? Memory map cache, no? We will discuss, no? The actual example. Actually, there are three, ano, no? Three different approaches to cache memory. Nandito tayo, no? So ito, basically, no? When the CPU nowadays, no? The cache is usually used to bridge the gap between the bandwidth of the CPU and the main memory. Usually the speed of main memory, how much is the speed of DDR4 nowadays? No? 2133 megahertz. Do you follow? And then let's look at the Core i7. speed. Okay. So ang Core i7 is 2.9 gigahertz to 4.2 gigahertz. Ang Core i3 is 3.4 to 4.3 gigahertz. Pero ang ano is megahertz lang. Okay? So it's like comparing millions and billions. Kasi megahertz lang siya. Gigahertz yung ating CPU. Do you follow? It's like comparing pesos and dollars. No, there's no way to compare. If you have 10,000 pesos and $10,000, you can throw away the 10,000 pesos because it's much smaller, no? Kasi how much is $10,000 nowadays? $250,000, tama ba? $250,000 a pesos. Eh yung peso na ano mo, 10,000, 10,000 lang, it's not even, no? Ang 10% ng 250,000 is 25,000. It's not even 10%. Na. So that's the main purpose of the cache, no? To bridge the gap between the difference, the speed difference, the transfer rate difference between the CPU and main memory. No? So the cache is like a fast memory which is small. Why can't they just build a large memory which is as fast as the cache? Basically, no, the cache memory is made of capacitive transistors, no? Sinong dumating? Sige lang, check ko lang ulit, no? Made of solid state transistors. Okay, so they will occupy a very large space, no, when put on the motherboard. While the main memory nowadays is made of capacitors. Capacitive, so maliliit sila, no, but very slow. And they occupy a small space. So kung we can just create a large memory without occupying so much space and without incurring so much cost, no? Ibig sabihin, talagang mahal kung at saka expensive, no? In terms of space and cost, if you are going to build cash. Okay? So, if you look at the cash, no? Ito yung mga cash differences between the old computers, no? Lalo na ngayon, L3 na ngayon ang uso ngayon, di ba? L3 na. Associative and set associative index. P4 ito. L1 cash lang siya. L2 and L3 cash, no? Let's Google that. Anyway, I think I'm sure it's in the net, no? It's usually cash comparison between Intel and AMD. Hindi nagsulat dito. L3 cash sila pala. Pero but I would like to look at the cash, no? In terms of the different levels. No? So ito yung sa AMD, no? Na 6 cash, no? So the L1 cash is 2.3 gigahertz. Okay? So if your speed is the memory is 4.3 megahertz. Now, if your CPU is 4 gigahertz, so the L1 cache, which is the highest, the fastest cache, no, also the smallest, is usually the nearest to the CPU, no, to the processor. So it's only 1/2 the speed of the CPU, diba? So hindi masyadong magkalayo, because if you have a processor which is 4 gigahertz. And you will have an L1 cache which is 2 gigahertz. So, medyo okay lang sila. Halos, kumbaga, parang si Usain Bolt at saka si whoever is a Philippine runner. Okay? So, hindi sila magkalayo. Although kalahati lang, no? And then the L2 cache, which is less than 1/2 of the L1 cache. But it's bigger. So usually when CPU accesses speed memory, it looks for it in the L1 cache. If it's there, the L1 cache gives it right away. So mabilis. But if it's not in the L1 cache, it will go to the L2 cache. Now the page swapping, okay, between the L1 and L2 is faster than L2 and L3, and also faster than direct memory. Do you follow? Okay. Okay, so mas mabilis pa rin. The worst case that can happen is that it's not in the L1 cache, it's not in the L2 cache, it's not in the L3 cache, it's from main memory, which rarely happens according to the principle of locality, because programs just don't go far away, no? They just travel within a vicinity of code. Okay, do you follow? Usually during a load time, no? Of course, during load time it's a different picture, no? Because programs are totally loaded from main memory to the cache and to the CPU. Okay, do you get my point? This is a very good example, oh, kasi the memory is 47 Mbps, and then the L1 cache is 2.3 gigahertz, and the 8.8.2.3.4, and then the L2 is, and we know that a CPU now, a processor now, Core i7 is 4 gigahertz. We follow. So kung 2 gigahertz yung ano, magkalapit na lang sila. Okay? Any questions so far? No. So that's the main purpose of the cache. So we have 3 levels of cache, no? Because the more levels, the lesser the miss. Ang tawag dyan kasi yan, when you look for an item in memory and it's there, it's called a hit. A hit is efficient. But if it's not there, it's called a miss. A miss is expensive because it will go down to the levels of memory to swap, no, the necessary blocks in order to fetch the given address. Okay, so why is cache reduce or rather split into different levels. Dati kasi there's only one level of cash. Now in the past, no, there's only one level of cash. Now CPUs nowadays have two levels and three levels. We have with three levels of cash, no, there will be lesser hits, lesser miss. The hit ratio will be higher. That's called the hit ratio, which means that if you have 100 tries and you will have a hit ratio of 70% of the time, you will find it in cash, no. So the hit ratio is higher if you have three levels. Okay, kasi kung hindi siya sa ano, wala siya sa L1, it will look for it in the L2. If it's not in L2, look for it in L3, and if it's not in L3, then it will look for the address in the main memory this time. Okay? Do you follow? No. So ganun, no. Okay, so so ito yung comparison ng mga cache of L1 to L2 in terms of sizes, but in terms not in terms of speed, no. You follow? We know that the L1 cache is the smallest. The L2 is the next biggest. Kung blank, ibig sabihin wala siyang L2. So nowadays, no, all computers have L3 cache. So 32 KB, pinakamalaki yung L3 pero pinakamabagal. Okay? You follow? Of course, the last level is the RAM. Okay. So ganyan yung ano, cache memory structure. Now there's the direct map. Ito yung cache, no? It is a smaller portion and this is memory. Now let's look at the different algorithms that are used to manage a cache, no? There are three different methods, algorithms that is used to manage the cache. First is the direct map cache. Second is the associative map cache, and the third is the set associative map cache. I'll give you a problem later on this, no. So I have an Excel worksheet, no, which you can download. Meron din akong illustration. May illustration dito, no. Let's look at the illustration first. How is the direct map cache done, no? So you have a certain number of blocks in the cache, no. Memory is organized into groups called blocks. Usually a block, the block size in terms of bytes is a power of 2. Power of 2 kasi binary yung ano ni, para madali mag ano, compute. Okay? So in a direct map cache, it's like this, no? You have blocks in memory. Okay, do you follow? Which can be transferred to a particular block in cache, no? Now, a block in memory is also the same size block in the cache. But in this case, not all blocks in memory can be loaded to the cache. Only a set. In this case, only there are 8 blocks. No? From time to time, if an address is fetched, okay, by the CPU or the memory address register, it will look for it in the cache and check if the block is there. If the block is there, it will load the whole block into the designated block in the cache. Otherwise, it will just give the address, the content of that address from the cache. You follow? So ganyan yung ano. I have a better illustration, no? Meron akong worksheet dyan, no? That illustrates better where's that? Direct map cache sample worksheet, okay? Can you download this, everyone? Direct map cache, no? An example worksheet of direct map cache, and I have a set of exercises that we can solve. No, we solve together. By the way, no. Hirap itong bagong Excel. Don't know how to shortcut because I'm storing my. I have a lot of files. Although I know how to look for them. Pero mahirap talaga. Okay. There are two sheets, no? There's the diagram of the cache and then the sample addresses. We'll try to find out how they're computed. Okay? They follow? No, medyo gusto ko sana makita yung dalawa eh, at the same time. Anyway, it's like this, no? There's an address, no? From the memory address register, which is 8 bits. Now, this is a, we are assuming that smaller size ito, no? Okay? It's like a small Lego. Lego, no? Gumagamit tayo ng Lego. It's a smaller type of a real one. Miniature version of the memory. We assume that we only have 1 to 8 bytes of memory and we have a cache of 32 bytes. Each block is, this is the block number, no? This is a block, no? This is the cache with 8 blocks. This is block 0, block 1, block 2, block 3, block 4, block 5, block 6, block 7. So each block has a different color, no? Each block can contain 4 bytes, no? I originally tested 8 bytes, pero mas more complicated eh. Do you follow? So yellow yung block. This is now in main memory we have 1 to 8 blocks divided by 8 rather 4 bytes. We have 1 to 8 bytes divided by 4 bytes. How many blocks do we have? We will have 32 blocks, no? Do you follow? 32 blocks tayo. Okay? 32 blocks because we have 128 bytes and each block divided by 4. So 128 divided by 4 that's 64. Divided by 2, that's 64. Divided by another 2, that's 32. So there are 32 different blocks, no? Pero ang sa ating cache, we can only occupy 8 blocks at a time. And you notice that alternating blocks, no? Ano bang gusto pong masok? Participants. A block, a cache block is like a theater, cinema. Diba? Pag pupunta ka sa sine, except that it's a reserved cinema, which means that kung mag-reserve ka ng seat, and then two people reserve one seat, so they take turns. Okay? So these areas in memory, which are colored yellow, are assigned to block zero, which means that if they are fetched at a given address, they will be placed here. Okay? So for example, address 000 to address 00011, which is 3, will be placed there. Now, there are other yellows. For example, in the 1 to 8 memory, there are 4 yellows. Like, for example, block 8. To block 8, which has an address of 32. Huh? Ito, pwede rin ito dito sa block, first block. So, block 8 and then block 16 and another yellow, which is block 24. So there are 24 blocks in memory that could share one block in the cache. Magsishare sila, alternate sila. Do you follow? Do you get my point? So for example, and then remember that the CPU directly addresses the cache, not the main memory. Okay? Do you follow? Do you follow? So for example here, if you are given an 8-bit, 7, ilan ba ang address natin? 1, 2, 8, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 7-bit address, no? Sorry, this is 7 bits. 7-bit address tayo because 1, 2, 8 tayo eh, from 0 to 1 to 7, that's a 7-bit address. Do you follow? So we say the memory address register has a given address, a 7-bit address. How are we going to fetch? How is the algorithm according to the RecMap cache fetch going to correct to get the correct byte in memory? Do you follow? Okay. Do you follow? Okay. First, we are going to divide the address into 3 different zones. No. First, we are going to compute for the offset. The offset is the address of the byte within a block. No. There are 4 bytes in a block, so the offset bits is 2. The address required will become 2 bits. So ito, 2 bits yung offset. Do you follow? Why? Because the offset address of a block is 00, 01, 10, 11. Okay? Dito. Okay? We will give an actual address later, no? And then, the next part. So, this will occupy, usually, the block size is a power of 2. Like here, the block size is 4. Okay, 4. So, 4 is a power of 2. So, 2 squared. B here, the power of 2 of the block size, which is 2, will count the offset bits. The offset bits is 2 bits. Okay? Do you follow? So that the remaining bits will actually occupy the will actually occupy the block in memory. Okay? So the block address is, what is the block address? The MAR address is the MAR address. Minus the B bits. Do you follow? Do you follow? So let's look at that, no? Tingnan natin. So there are 2 bits that are used for B, di ba? Do you follow? So let's take a look at this part. At the first 8 bytes, I'm sorry. Palakihin ko nga ito. Ito, no? Can you see that? Okay na ba? I hope it's okay, no? If you look at that, no? Tatanggalin natin itong dalawa. So the block address is 00000. 00000. Ilang zeros? 5 zeros. Okay? Do you follow? So take a look at that. These 5 zeros actually refer to block number 0, which means dito sa block. Dito sila sa block number 0 occupy. Okay? Look at the next block, which is 001. Pareho yung first 5 bits. The B bits is 2. Tatanggalin natin yung 2 bits. So, 00001 tells us that dito siya sa block 1 ma-assign. Do you follow? Do you follow? So, it's a hash function. If you look at the blue one, the third block, 0001, 0001. Okay? 0010, 0010, dito sa 2. So, dito sila ma-assign. Okay? Look at, so we just, by looking at the first 5 bits, we know the where the block in memory and the block in the cache correspond. Di ba? Now, let's look at another yellow. If you look at another yellow, here's a yellow here. Okay? Dito sa dulo. Okay. Paano ba ang computation ng block nito? Okay. 01000. 01000. Actually, meron tayong tatanggalin dito, no? Do you follow? To determine the actual block size. Okay, we'll have to find out later, no? In short, shortly, no? Do you follow? So the block address in memory is MAR minus B bits in memory. Okay. So the cache blocks is 2 to the 3. Do you follow? Do you follow? The number of blocks in the cache is 2 to the 3. Okay? Do you follow? So if you remove the 3 bits to the right of the block address, that's the actual block address in the cache. Of which? In the cache. Do you follow? I'll upload this again. Okay? How did we compute the 3 bits? The number of blocks in the cache. How many blocks are there in the cache? 8 blocks. Okay. So log 2 of 8 is 3. 2 to the 3 is 8. Do you follow? So in the remaining, ano, no? In the remaining, ano, in the remaining 5 bits, kasi tinanggalan 7 bits, tinanggalan natin dalawang B bits, 5 na lang. So out of the 5, the first 3 bits actually point to the block in the cache, in memory. Okay, can we look at that, no? Do you follow? So ito, no? Ano ang first five nito? 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. The last three is 0, 0, 0. Do you follow? So which points that it this means that this is in 0, 0, 0. Ito sila. And this one naman, the last three is 0, 0, 0, 1. Itong first three, 0, 0, 1. Okay? Which means that they point here. This one here is 0, 1, 0. Okay? So 0, 1, 0. So they point to the blue one here. Now, let's look at the next yellow. Okay, the next yellow. The next here is the next yellow, no? 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. So the last is 0, 0, 0, which means they also point to the same block. Dito siya dapat malalagay. Because the last three, the first three bits of the remaining, no? Aside from the offset, point to the block. Okay? So let's look at the next zero, the next yellow. The next yellow is in which address? The next yellow is in address 64. Okay? The value is 1, 0. Tanggalin natin yung, we remove the last two bits. 1, 0, 0, 0. So, the block address of the memory, the first three bits of the block address of memory is 0, 0, 0. Which means that dito rin siya naka-point. Do you follow? The number of blocks, that is if the number of blocks in the cache memory is also a power of 2. Okay? So, kompleto na tayo. What's the three bits? The first three bits is the offset. The first three bits of the remaining points to the block in the cache. And the last two bits is called the tag bit. Do you follow? Ito ang importante, yung tag bit. Actually, this is the first two bits, no? The last two bits remaining. Remaining is the tag bit. What is the use of the tag bit? The tag bit is used to identify whether the correct block is being addressed by the memory address register. Ito yung that's how the CPU will identify whether it is the byte in this block and not the byte on this other yellow block or any other yellow block. Do you follow? Okay? You get my point? Medyo complicated siya isipin, no? Pero actually, simple lang. It's just like a theater where seats are common. They're assigned seats, no? Now, those who are who share the same seat may have to take they have to schedule their viewing because they cannot view at the same time. Okay? Do you follow? They have to schedule katulad nito, no? Okay? Any questions so far? So, ganun yung pagano. The first two bits, the less significant bits, is called the offset of a given address. Okay? Actually, it's still a serial address. Okay? And then the next three bits, which is all computed by the number of the cache blocks. Now, the offset is computed by the size of each block. Okay? Log 2 of the size of each block. Each block has a size of 4. Log 2, 4 is 2. So, we need two bits for the offset. The next is the cache blocks. The cache blocks is the log 2 of the number of blocks in the cache. There are 8 blocks. So log 2 of 8 is 3. 2 to the 3 is 8. So you have 3 bits. And the remaining is the 2 bits. Sana makita ko itong dalawa, no? Let me just open another Excel. Bigyan ko na lang itong sample addresses. Okay. Tapos dito ko ilalagay yung exercise, okay? Bakit ayaw mag-paste? Close ko muna to. Sinong dumating lang? Kararating? Espera?
Yes, sir.
Sino pa yung dumating?
Yung mga 136.
Yung bagong dating ba? Jesus, tapos na. Arellano de Guran. Arellano de Guran. At yan, sir. Tapos na. I have to transfer this kasi it goes in the way. Na? Kung makita sa bay. Na? Okay. Kasi ko kasi sila makita sa bay. For example, we have the address 2. The address 2. Okay. Ito yung ating actual cache, no? We follow, so may laman ito na 101234, no? So ang content nito, these are the contents. Format cells. Ito yung offset, no? This is offset address 0, 1, 2. Ito yung, hindi natin ito makoloran kasi depende na. No? For example, the memory address register contains a value of 2. Okay? Villar Luares. Okay. Okay. For example, the memory address register contains a value. Let's convert this into the binary equivalent. We can use that to bin and then 7 bits because we have 7 bits. Let's expand this. I think we need to expand this. Okay, you follow. Ilagay ko na lang sana siguro dito ang ano, no? Tag cache and offset, no? Tag cache. Cache block. Hmm? Palakihin ko na lang, no? Cache tag offset. Then we'll remove this. Do you follow? So ano ang offset dito? The offset is 10, diba? Because 2 to the B. 2. Okay? The tag here is 00, the first 2. And the cache, and the cache block is, okay? Kasi sa 5, okay? Sa 5 remaining, kukunin natin yung 3 bits, assign it to the cache block. Di follow? Ang tag niya is 00. Di follow? Which means that it's the same, no? Ano? Okay? Now, if that's the value, no? Di follow? So galing ito, we know that this is from this cache block. And we know that this address is from address 2 offset 2. Ito yung 2 na ito, no? And this is 2 in the actual memory. Ito yung 2 sa actual memory. Ito yung 2 dito sa block. Or dito sa cache, no? Cache block. Do you follow? So, it's a miss. So, we will load. Saan siya ilalagay ngayon? Ilo-load natin. So now this becomes valid, no? And then we will put the tag. Okay? We will now put it in cache 0. Ito yung cache index, no? So block 0, block 1, block 2, block 3. Gawin natin itong yellow. Kasi yellow ito eh. And then ito. Gawin natin. Ganito ba? Yeah. And then ito. Gawin natin. I hope I can still remember colors. Ito ba yun? Ito, no? No? I think it's this. Ito ba? Ito. Yeah. Yan, no? Kasi ito, this is supposed to be red. This is red. Tama ba? And then this is blue. Yeah. And then paano itong block? Okay. So gawin natin itong white. And then gawin natin white, and then this one will use a block. Okay. It's a block siya. And then this one will use what color is this? Ito ba siya? Ito ba? No. Yate. No. No color ito. It's not this one. Ito yata. Ito ba? No. Sabihin ko na lang. Then going from 110. Okay. Then we'll put it in the middle. Okay. And this 111 is green. Saan problema sa green? Diba? O ito. Ito. Okay. Do you follow? So ganyan. Ganun, no? Ito yung pihin ko na lang. Let me copy this first. I will upload it to your ano, no?
Sir, nalang ko i-clarify po, sir.
Yes,
okay. Ano yung purpose ganyan ng tag bits, sir?
Ang tag bits is the remaining, kasi yung naiwan na bit, tinanggal natin yung ano, di ba? Tinanggal natin yung offset. You know what the offset is, right?
Yes.
Ito nga, pag tapos ang remaining, pag tinanggal mo yung, if you remove the offset, the remaining is 5 bits. Tapos ang cache block address lang is 3 lang. So may naiwan na dalawa. Okay? May naiwan na dalawa kasi in main memory, we need 5 bits to address all blocks because there are how many? 32 blocks.
Yes po.
32 blocks, pero dito sa cache, 8 blocks lang. Ang 32 blocks will require 5 bits. Right? Pero ang blocks na nandito sa cache, 8 lang, so it will only require 3 bits. Okay?
Yes po.
So the difference is called the tag bit. We are going to identify if it is the tag bit is used to identify whether kasi the correct block in memory is in the cache. Yun ang gamit ng tag. Kasi dito sa block 1, ilang blocks sa memory ang pwedeng mag-share nito? How many blocks will share? There are 4 blocks. Do you follow?
Yes.
There are 4 blocks na yellow. 4 sila na share on the same seat. Ngayon, paano natin malaman sino sa kanila ang nakaupo dyan?
Ah, sige, sige. Thank you,
Professor. Sa tag natin. That's why we use the tag. Do you follow? Do you follow?
Yes, po. Salamat po, sir.
So usually, the tag here is placed in the cache. So dito sa ano sa cache, merong tayong tag. Ilalagay dito. Dito na lang siguro natin ilagay ang tag. Ilalagyan ng tag yung cache. Do you follow? Do you follow? Okay? So for example, nag-miss tayo kasi the CPU asks for the binary address 000010. Do you follow? Anong offset nito? 10. Ang block is cache block is 000, ang tag is 00. Ilalagay natin dito yung 00. Do you follow? Ay sorry, kulang ng ano. 00. Okay? Where did we get the 00 tag? Where did we get the 00 tag? Yung tag dito sa address, itong tag na to nilipat natin dyan. Do you follow? Do you get my point? We will use the tag who the proper occupant is in the cache. Kung hindi siya ang proper occupant, we will ask him to vacate so that the proper occupant can take his place. Do you follow? Medyo ano, no? Medyo disgrace, medyo rude, no? It's rather rude that you are already sitting on a seat and you will be asked to leave the seat because the proper occupant has come. Di ba? Ikaw naman na ating nakaupo dyan. Okay? Can we proceed now? Okay, the next address is 3. Shall we say the memory address has got another, which is 3. So what is the offset bit here? 11, di ba? Yan yung offset, 11, no? Ang block is 000. The tag is 0000. So now with the block address of 00, titingnan ngayon dito sa cache, is the block address 00 here? Is block address in 00? Yes. Yes, oh, yes. Di ba? Which means that the CPU does the memory, the cache doesn't have to go to memory to fetch. This is a hit. Ito ang tinatawag na hit. Ibig sabihin, nakachamba siya nandun sa memory. Now, how sure is he, is the cache, that it's there, that is the correct, that it's the correct block? Because there are 3 other blocks. Any questions? Any answers? How sure is the memory, the cache, that this is a hit? Na nandun sa cache. Titingnan niya yung tag. You follow? Ano ang tag ngayon na nandito sa address? Yun na ngayon nagtanong, si Dwight? Di Jesus?
Yes po.
Ikaw yung nagtanong, di ba?
Opo.
Di ba? Ngayon, yes, titingnan niya, ano ang tag na nandito ngayon sa cache? 00. Ano ang tag na nandito sa bagong address? 00. They are the same. Which means that it's a hit. Talagang, ibig sabihin, hindi na siya pupunta sa memory because this is the correct block. Did you follow? That's why this is a hit. Okay? We follow? Now, let's look for a different address, which is address 16. I hope you're getting the point now, no? Malapit na yung oras natin. So, what's the tag? 00. Sorry. Hirap talaga ito i-explain, no? What's the block? 100. What's the offset? 00. Do you follow? Ngayon, titingnan niya ngayon yung block. Which block is it? 1000. It's not occupied. But it's not in the yet, no? So this is a miss. So what will happen? It will load. Iloload niya yung galing sa memory, ilalagay niya dito. And this is tag 00. Ilalagay niya yung tag. And then this is now occupied. Do you follow? Occupied na. And then yung 21. Address 21, okay? What's the tag? 00. What's the block? 101. What's the offset? 0-1. Okay. So titingnan natin yung cash block. 1-0-1. Is 1-0-1 there? No. Kasi wala pa. Oh. So this is a miss. I-load niya yan. Kasi wala, di pa naka-load niya. Pag ma-miss, i-load niya. Papalitan niya yung nakaupo dito. So ilagay niya dito ngayon si tag. Dito si tag 00, no? Dito ilagay niya si tag 00. Okay? Do you follow? So it doesn't matter here kasi wala pang nakaupo. But still, it's considered a miss. Kasi wala pa siya sa cash. Okay? Do you follow? Gusto ko matingnan yung 64. Now, let's compute this. This is, okay. So, what's the tag? 00. What's the cash block? 011. Okay. What's the offset? 01. Okay. So, the tag is 011. What is this? A miss or a hit? 011. Bakit? Ito, 011. This is a miss. Kasi wala pa eh. Ibig sabihin, paupuin natin siya ngayon sa 011. This is now occupied and this is occupied by tag 00. Do you follow? 00. Now ngayon, si 64. Save ko na lang ito, no? We'll continue with this next meeting. No? Ito lang pinakamahirap, eh, no? It's the one that's really difficult. From iba, madali na lang. Okay, do you follow? So, na-miss ngayon. Nakaupo na. May nakaupo na ngayon. Let's follow this. 64. So, ngayon, ito ang problema. Do you follow? What's the tag? 10. What's the cash? 123. What's the offset? 00. Do you follow? So, Jesus, are you still there?
Yes po, sir.
Ito ngayon ang tanong. Si cashback 000, nandyan, occupied, valid, right?
Yes po.
Are we going to use this cash block to fetch this address?
Murag dili ata, sir. Dili sa siguro.
Why?
Kay kasi, ma-daot ang ito, structure sa
lahi data. Lahi man siya nga block. This is a different block, di ba? This in memory. Because this one in memory is this is the block in memory sa currently naka-occupy. Pero ngayong block, yung bagong block, ito yung bagong block na dumating, si block 64. Do you follow? So we cannot use the content of the cache. We cannot use the cache to give the content to the CPU. Pwede ba natin gamitin yung cache? Ibigay natin sa CPU. Oh, ito yun, oh. Ito. Hindi. Because this is a different area in memory. Do you follow? Kasi 64 yung address nito, ito ang address 2. They have the same block address. Yes. But they do not refer to the same byte. Do you follow? How do we know that they don't refer to the same byte? Jesus, ikaw naman lang isa nabilin. Apitam na maman. How do you know that they don't refer to the same byte?
They don't
have the same tag.
Yes, sir.
Kasi on sa may tag ani 10, kini ang tag ani 000. So they are not the same. So therefore this is a miss and replace. Do you follow? So ngayon paalisin natin yung si tag 00. Paalisin natin siya ngayon. Ibabalik natin siya sa memory. That's what the cache does during a miss. Okay? Ibabalik sa memory, i-reload ngayon si tags 1-0. So ngayon, si dito na siya ang naka-occupy. Palit na tayo ngayon ng ano. Iba na yung nakaupo ngayon. Do you follow? Do you get my point? No. So now, do you know why, how to use the tag to determine the correct block? Diba? So si 66. Let's go to that. No. So what's the block address? 1-0. What's the tag of the block address is 000. And the offset address is 1-0, right? Okay. Ngayon, the block address is 00. And is the cache valid? Yes. Oh, nakalagay valid. Right? Valid siya, yes. So which means we have a high chance na hindi na tayo makahit. Is it the correct tag? Si Jesus lang yung tayo nabilin. Espera, are you there?
No, sir.
Asan mo si Espera day?
Hey, different po yung tag, sir.
Okay, parehong tag, oy. Parehong tag, oh. 1-0. Ang tag na nandun ngayon sa task.
Ay, okay. Aya pala.
This is a, what do you call this? This is a hit. Ibig sabihin, hindi na tayo pupunta dun sa memory. Nandyan na, ibibigay na natin kagad. Do you follow? Bisaya at tagamay, ha? To make things easier, okay? Do you follow? Okay, last address. We will just wrap this up, no? This is what? Tag address is 01. The cache block address is 011. And the offset address is 10. Do you follow? So ngayon, si 011. Do you follow? Is 011 valid in the cache?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Is this a hit?
No. It's a miss.
It's a miss. Why?
Different
tag.
Why ngayon yung tag? So anong gagawin natin kay tag 00?
Replace.
Palisin. Oh, you go back to memory. I-save siya ng tama. Okay? I-save siya ng tama. It will be saved to memory. Okay? So this is a miss and replace. Sinong paupuin natin dito ngayon? So 011? Si
01.
Palit na. Iba na ngayon yung nakaupo. Ay, sorry, no? Okay. Iba na ngayon yung nakaupo dyan. Okay. Can you continue this? No, it's there. They follow? Continue this and then hindi ko na lang ipapas, no? Okay. They follow? You also watch the video, no? Okay. This is a simple ano, this is a simple concept pero ang hirap nito intindihin pag wala kang actual exercise, no? So you have to solve this because we are going to include this in our summative assessment. Can you continue with this? We're running out of time. 1:30 to 2:30 ba tayo? Or hanggang 3 o'clock? Baka mali ako, no? Kasi kung mali ako, we'll just finish this. Mali ba ako?
3 o'clock ata, sir.
At 3 o'clock ba? Let me just check. Kung 3 o'clock, pwede natin ito tapusin, no? 3 o'clock, right? Oh, at 3 o'clock pala tayo, so tapusin na natin ito, no? So, ayan. Okay? We follow? Okay. Now, the next address is 19. Okay, see. Nasi attend, sir, ya?
Yes, sir.
What's the tag?
00, sir.
00. Oh, see? Kinsa pinaad, ya?
100 yung cache block, sir.
100. Tapos, what's the offset?
11, sir.
11, okay. 100. Is 100 there?
No, sir.
It's not valid, so this is a miss, right?
Yes, sir.
Pero bakante pa sa 100.
Yes, sir.
Bakante pa, so wala tayong isi-save. Wala tayong palisin. So we'll just validate this as yes. And then what tag are we going to store here? 00.
00, sir.
I'm sorry. Okay. I'm sorry. Hindi tayo maganda. Sorry, ito pala. Yan, si 00. May nakaupo na ngayon. Sa cache na yan. Now we have number 11. Okay. So sino pwede magtatanungin? Is Duguran there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what's the tag?
00, sir.
00. What's the block?
010.
010. What's the offset?
11.
Where do we look for in the class? 010. So what is this?
Miss, sir.
Miss, pero bakante pa.
Yes, sir.
So this we will occupy this. Wala tayong palisin. Okay? And sir, then what our tag will now be?
00.
00. May nakaupo na. May dalawang bakante na lang. You follow? The next address is 3. Ayan, dumating si 3. So, sino ang tatanungin natin dyan? Villar Luares? Are you there? Natutulog na siya? Oh, no, mic. Oh, sige. Villar Luares on mic. What's the tag? 00. Good. Okay. What's the cash block? 00. Good. What's the offset? 11. Okay. So we look for 000. 000 is valid, right? Valid, yes, oh. Valid, yeah, right? Is it valid? Villar Luares? Valid, yes. Is it the correct block? Villar Luares, is it the correct block? What's the result? It's not the correct block because the tag here is 10 and the tag here is 00, right? Diba? So this is a miss and replace. Okay? Villar Luares, you follow? Iko-compare mo lang naman eh. You just have to compare the tag here and the tag here. They are not the same. So this is not the correct block. So what will we do with block 10? We are going to save it back to memory. Do you follow? And what are we going to go to do with tag 00? We are going to bring it back, no, load it to the tag or to the cache. So this now becomes 00. Do you follow? Villar Luares? Did you follow? Okay, good. Now let's go to 22. At least I'm sure that you're not sleeping. Okay. Who do we ask here? Espera.
Sir.
Oh, what's the tag here?
01.
Huh? The tag is the two leftmost.
Right, two leftmost. 00.
00. What's the cash block?
101.
101. What's the offset?
10.
10. So we look for the cash block 101, right? Is it valid?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. Is it the correct block?
Yes, sir.
Yes. What do you call this?
Hit.
Hit. Ibig sabihin, hindi na tayo pupunta sa memory. Tama na tayo dito. Okay? Hit. Okay? Okay. Sinong nandyan? Sinong hindi pa natin natanong? Arellano, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What's the tag?
00, sir.
00. What's the cash?
001.
001. What's the offset?
00.
00. So we look for 001. Is it valid?
Yes, sir.
Yes, valid. Oh, 001 is valid. Is it the correct block?
Yes, sir.
Yes, because they have the same tag. So what do you call this?
Hit, sir.
Okay. Which means that right away we respond, or we give the address, we give the content to the memory buffer register. Okay? Bibigyan na natin sa memory buffer register kung anong content na. Because it's a hit. Okay? Sino pa hindi natin natanong? Tapos naman si Dabon. Dabon, are you there?
Sir.
Yes, what's the tag here?
00, sir.
00. What's the block?
011.
011. 0, 1, 1. What's the offset?
1, 0.
1, 0. Sir. 1, 0. So we are looking for block 0, 1, 1. Is 0, 1, 1 valid?
Yes, sir.
Yes. But is it the 0, 1, 1? But is it the correct block?
No, sir.
So what do you call this?
Miss or miss. And replace.
And replace. Which means that it will be saved to memory and the new block will be transferred. And then 011 will now be marked 00. Do you follow? Okay na. Okay. Tapusin lang natin ito, no? And then next meeting will aba na. Sino pang hindi natin natanong? Jesus, Oriano, Villares, Espera. Si Atian sir, tapos na ba tayo? Tapos na si Atian sir, no?
Yes, sir.
Sino hindi natanong natin?
Natanong na ata lahat, sir.
Ah, ikaw na lang at yan, sir. Balik na. Kung baga, bumalik na tayo. Just like a cash, no? Pagkatapos, balik yes, sa taas. Balik sa taas. Cash.
Yes, sir. 00, yeah. Sir.
00?
And 001.
001.
10.
Zero. So we're looking for block 001.
Yes, sir.
07, yes.
It's a hit, sir.
It's a hit. So no problem. It's a hit. Okay. And then we look at this. This is the address. Sinong next? Jesus?
Yes, sir.
Yes, what's the tag?
Ang tag 01.
01. What's the block?
010.
010. What's the offset?
11.
Okay. 11. What's the, we are looking for block 010. 010 is valid. Yes.
Miss, valid, sir, pero miss and replace.
Pero miss and replace. Kasi, so ang ibig sabihin ng miss and replace, we are going to save the contents back to memory and we are going to load the new block. And then, 0, what that's 01, 010, and then we will now make this as 01. Okay. So, iba na nakaupo ngayon. Okay. 11. Isa ka ito paghuman ni Jesus kanina? Si Duguran?
Ah, yes, sir.
Sige.
00, sir.
00. And then what's the... What's
010.
010. And what's the offset?
11.
Offset, ibig sabihin the actual byte. We are looking for 010. 010 is yes. Right? Is it valid, 010?
Yes, sir.
Yes, valid. But it is it the correct block?
No, sir.
No. So, balik na naman yung ating pinaalis. Babalikin na naman natin ngayon. Diba? Pinaalis natin siya dito.
Yes, sir.
Okay, pabalikin na naman natin siya. Ano? Balik na naman. Okay? So, this is a miss and?
Replace.
Replace. Pabalikin natin siya. Ibalik natin siya dito as 00. Okay? Do you follow? So any questions? So now do you understand, no? The concept of the direct map cache, where the cache is shared, no? The cache which is very fast is shared by memory so that only one of the possible blocks assigned to the cache is able to take to occupy the cache at the time. Now, this is valid because this follows the principle of locality. Bihira lang naman daw, according to the principle of locality, it's rare to have a miss because we are not going to have four blocks, no? Four bytes in a cache. Usually, what's the cache? You'll have 32 MB of cache, no? L2 cache. So, no? So, ang L1, you have 16 KB, so 32 KB. So, more or less, it can occupy a large program. So, you have 32 KB of L1 cache and 256 or 1 MB of L2 cache. So, the bigger the cache, the smaller the hit rate, the smaller the miss, no? Chances of missing. So the bigger the cache, the higher the hit ratio. Okay, so one way, but it's expensive to increase the size of the cache. We can just increase the next level. So kung ma-miss mo dito sa first, you will have lesser hit miss ratio when you go to the next. Why? Because the next cache is much bigger than the first cache. For example, here in the PowerPC G4, The L1 cache is 32 KB. The next is 1 MB. So, kung mamiss ka pa rin dyan, dito sa L3, 2 MB. Kung mamiss ka pa rin, then you go to the ano, which is 4 GB. Do you follow? Do you get my point? Anyway, the replacement, the page replacement will be done simultaneously, no? Simultaneous naman yon, yung hindi kailangan anuhin, maghintayan, they will be done simultaneously. Okay, so what's the disadvantage of the direct map cache? Anyone? What do you think? What disadvantage can you see in this? Bation deyo? Si Bation? Oh, absent si Bation? Sorry na, absent pala siya. Arellano, what do you think? Is this disadvantage here? Arellano, are you there?
No idea, sir. Sorry.
Sige, isa-isayin natin. De Jesus? Ha?
Kayo.
Hindi kayo kasigurado?
Hi, sir. Yes. So, sir, nabay possibility na ang hash ka ng sagay na? Na sa itawag anang kanang sa hash kanang nani nag-occupy sa unsa
mo gani we can find out
collision
nag-occupy kita na una tong tag di ba
yes sir
so kung nag-occupy that's called a miss kung nani nag-occupy miss na siya okay so chamba-chamba po niyo sai dapat mas taas ang itong hit ratio now there's a problem here. Look at that blocks 110 and 111. What happened to blocks 110 and 111?
It's unused, sir.
Unused. Kumbaga sa ating ano, sa classroom pa, meron pang gustong pumasok. Hindi naman puno, pero hindi pa sila nakapasok.
Limitation sa yan sa number.
This is a limitation of the direct map cache kasi meron ka ng seat assigned. Now, if the seat assigned you are having is not vacant, you can't go in even if there are other seats vacant. Did you get my point? So, there's a smaller hit ratio. Sana kung ginamit ito, the number of misses will be reduced. Did you follow? So the problem with direct map cache in random generation of addresses is there may be certain parts of memory of memory that will never be used. And there are certain parts of the cache which will never be used. And it's inefficient because it's expensive and it was just sitting there vacant. Sana if there was a mechanism, okay, to find out that if the tag is different, then put it on the next vacant. Do you follow? Do not put it on the seat assigned because there's another vacant. Anyway, you're just going, pagdating ng ibang nang nakaupo, dapat uupo, palisin mo rin naman siya, di ba? You're going to replace him if the right owner will come again. So just put him temporarily on a vacant site. Do you get my point?
Yes, sir.
So the next algorithm which we are going to study is the algorithm on associative mapping. Do you follow? And then associative mapping also has its disadvantages. No? Hindi naman ganun talaga 'yon eh. There's no perfect technology. So, there's an alternative which is called the set associative mapping. Now for the moment, no, I'd like you to take a look in our ano sample problem for direct map cache, no? Ito. Can you solve this and then di ka muna ipapas, no? Next meeting na lang siguro, no? Given a memory of this and a cache of 81 or block size, determine the block number and the cache block address of the following addresses. Do you follow? Ito yun, 65K or 64K yung ating memory size. Okay, or 2 to the 16. Okay? And the cache of 8K or 2 to the 3. Okay? So, there are 8 blocks in the cache. Kasi one block size is 1K. Do you follow? ngayon, hanapin natin kung saan block ito sila malalagay. Do you get my point? Find the block in memory that this other cell should be placed. Okay? Ano man, kaya ito next meeting? Can you do this next meeting? Or ano na lang, Monday? A sample problem, Ramani. I'll give you another problem na lang. Okay? Can you just solve this? No? Determine the area in memory where you can have ano. I'll upload the new direct map cache kay may mga mali-mali. Kayo na lang mag-answer nung ano no? Direct map cache na test na worksheet. Palitan ko lang. Eh, bakit nagkaganon? Bakit ayaw? At lang, okay. So it's there, no? The sample worksheet. Okay. Any questions so far? Okay. We'll, this next meeting, we will discuss associative mapping. Maraming sources dito sa net, no? Instead of just our textbook. Did I miss anyone? Wala naman yata. Let me just check no, before I... Hindi naman yung madrag. Ano naman din yung madrag? Ang... Wala. Pati on, no? How and Hardinel. Is Hardinel here? Okay. So see you next meeting, no? No assignment. Just an exercise. It's up to you how to when you will do it. You will do it, no? Okay. Bye everyone.
Bye sir. Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
See you on Wednesday. Wednesday, ba?
Bye, po, sir.
Yes, sir.